mother's too much.
She can't help it. She loves you.
Why do you always have to leave so early?
I got meetings.
So you have a meeting today?
The kid knows his stuff. Hey, you gonna stay awake? Or am I gonna get another call?
Only happened once.
You gotta stay awake when you drive. I'll make you a deal. You stay awake, we'll take the boat out this weekend.
I thought you guys were already going to that.
Deal's a deal.
Everything's fine. Pike?
Don't push it.
Like father, like son.
Take care of your mom, huh? She's a pain in the ass. But she loves you. Throw at me, but you can't let it get too far. I need help with that because your mother will run it right into the ground like she did your grandfather and the goddamn dog in the weekly acupuncture sessions. I don't want to be in a hospital bed hooked up to a bunch of monitors like some vegetable. If the time should come, I want you to promise that that'll never happen. Can you do that for me?
What's your name?
Matty Matthews, sir, from New York.
Well, help me out here, Mr. Matthews. Florida, August of last year. The body of a 28-year-old female, Joanne D., was discovered in a marsh. She had been strangled and hastily buried, but left partially exposed. Now, this is a sexual homicide, but I'm not going to bore you with the prurient details of vaginal penetration or lack of semen evidence, because it's not material to the point I'm trying to make. The 65-year-old man who discovered her, Mr. Spencer, in some misguided attempt to rescue the girl, pulled her from the marsh and in doing so destroyed a lot of the latent evidence that might have been collected, such as footprints, etc. Furthermore, Mr. Spencer, in pulling the body from the marsh, cut himself. And his blood dripped onto the body of Joanne D. What can I do, Mr. Matthews, to solve this crime? Detective LaMarche?
Search for fiber, hair, blood splatter, even trace.
Detective Burke?
Run the profile through VICAT.
Detective Jury?
Do a background check on the old man.
Two months ago, Mr. Spencer was pulled over for driving an unregistered car, fake plates. Subsequent investigation revealed that the car was kept in a shed belonging to his sister. And inside the shed, shreds of Joanne D's fingernails, blood, and hair. We have our hands on the classic organized offender, and we let him go.
So why do debutantes hate group sex?
Jesus.
Because they have to write so many thank you notes. You live around here?
Oh, yeah, kind of. I mean, sort of. Yeah. No. I thought it was, you know, a good idea to just keep in touch with the, some of the people in the program.
You wouldn't believe what a mess this guy was.
Yeah, well. So, Lenny, what kind of work are you in?
Surgeon. Huh. I'm through.
I'm sorry. If I did stuff to make it hard for you, it's only because I was having problems, too.
You always have problems.
I know. I always have problems. I do always have problems. But if you're not around, I don't make it at all.
Somebody want to tell me what's happening here?
Nothing. Nothing's happening here.
Really? I'd like him to leave.
Fuck you.
Fuck me! Fuck me! No, no. Fuck you! You're in my house now, asshole! So get the fuck out!
dude.
I don't know.